Hey everybody, this is Viren and welcome back to my YouTube channel for another marketing tutorial. Now, as some of you have been emailing me and requesting me to start making tutorials on Google AdWords, I thought I'll get started with that. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to basically create your first search ad on Google. As you might know that Google Ads is the platform from where you can make multiple type of ads, that being search campaigns, display campaigns, app install campaigns, and even YouTube campaigns. So basically you have access to all the kinds of ads Google lets you create on all of their platforms. But for this tutorial, we'll get started with search campaigns. And as you can see, I'm using the new Google AdWords UI compared to the previous one. So in case you're still using the old one, you will see a button somewhere at the bottom right corner of the screen, somewhere around here, which says try the new Google Ads Manager. And that is what I'm using for these tutorials. Once you've created your account, which is very simple to do, all you do is sign in with your regular Gmail ID, connect your card, and you'll land at this screen. Once you do, I'm under search campaigns, and as you can see, I don't have any campaigns right now. So I even get a message saying none of my campaigns are running because all of them are either paused or removed. So let's get started with our first search ad and click on this add button. You can also click on this new campaign button and create a new campaign. So there are a number of kind of campaigns you can create with Google Ads. We'll go over all of them one by one, but we'll start with the search network ad. But there's also the display ad, the shopping ads, the video ads for YouTube, and the app ads for the Play Store. But let's get started with search ads. Basically, the search ad will let you create ads on the Google search platform as well as their partner networks. So first you have to define a goal. You have to select whether you want visits to your website or you want a checkout on your website. You want them to call your business. In this case, your ad is going to have a phone number and it will be searchable through the phone, through the smartphones, and users can give you a call directly from your ad. For now, let me just select visits on the website, and the optional setting gives you an option to add the business address, but let me just continue for now. You need to give your campaign a name. Let me just call it Snapchat ads. Now, do you want it to be visible on just the search network or also the display network as well? So now what Google has started doing is that even if all you have is text, they will use your text and somehow make it into a display ad. But I will just select search ads for now. We will start by selecting the location. So let me just select Mumbai. So I'm selecting the city of Mumbai. The language is English. You can add a lot of other languages as well, but since my ad is going to be English, my website is in English, so I'll leave it at that. The bidding strategy, there are different kinds of bidding strategies to maximize clicks, conversions, a target cost per acquisition, things like that. I like to always first begin by manual CPC, get a good amount of data into my campaigns before I start using CPAs or conversions. So let me just start with manual CPC. Enable enhanced CPC. Now what this means is that AdWords will automatically adjust your bids for maximum conversion. I'll let that be active. You can start by entering a daily budget. So I'll keep it at a very minimal, say 100 rupees per day. The delivery method, standard or accelerated. Accelerated means that Google will try and use your entire budget as quickly as possible. And standard means that it will spread it throughout the day. So if you're just beginning, I'll say you select standard because then you get to know what time of the day your ad works the best and then you can optimize accordingly. Star and end dates, I have no end date set. I'll start it immediately from today, which is 31st October. We'll get into sitelinks, callouts, and call extensions later, but for now I'm not adding all of this. There are more settings as well. So you can add a lot of these things. You can schedule your ad for certain time of the day or certain days of the week. You can have rotational settings. That means that if you have multiple ads, you can decide how Google will give more preference to one ad over the other. Or do you want them to distribute all your ads evenly. You can add campaign URL options. What this means is that you can add a template, you can add basically UTM parameters to your campaign so that you can track what is the traffic coming from this particular campaign. I usually add UTMs on an ad basis so that I can track each of my ads. If you don't know what UTM parameters are, I'll link up another video somewhere here in that I button, and you can click and watch this video to know what UTM parameters are. It basically helps you track conversions from each of your ads. Let's click on save and continue. Now we need to create an ad group. What ad group in Google search basically means is that this is where you list down what are the keywords you want to be targeting and what is the amount you want to pay per click. So let me just give my ad group a name. I'll just call it ad group 1. And I'll set with a default bid of say 2 rupees CPC. Let me add some keyword. So there are a number of ways you can add keywords. As you can see that if you just add the keywords like I've added right now, it's something called broad match. What this means is that even if someone, say my keyword was Snapchat ads, but someone typed Snapchat advertising and Google thinks it is still relevant, your ad still might be shown to them. If you add quotation marks around your keyword, what that means is Google will only show your ad if that exact phrase is there, that phrase is there in the search that has been made. Another thing is called exact match, where you add these brackets around your keyword. What this means is that Google will show your ad only if the searched keyword is exactly this. So I always like to start with broad match and then slowly remove the keywords that don't make sense. We'll get into this again later. Now you can also use this to get keyword ideas. Like if you enter your website's name or a link to your website, Google will scan your website and come up with keywords that might help you. You can also enter a product or service like say Snapchat marketing, and now Google has given me some options of keywords and as well as the monthly searches around it, so I can add keywords that makes sense for me. And you can also see the monthly searches that are made for these. And as you keep adding keywords, you'll see that how much cost Google estimates you will make and what is the average CPC. So you can decide on a default bid based on this. And probably what I can see here is that not too many searches are made around these keywords. That is why Google is estimating that I'm not going to get any clicks in the day. But you will actually learn once you start creating ads that these numbers aren't always accurate. The CPCs can be way more or way less than what Google suggests, so it's always good to experiment on your own first. So even though these estimates are way too low, I'll still go ahead with my campaign and let me just see what kind of returns I get. If not, then you might want to use the Google keyword tool and see how many searches are made on your keywords every day on a monthly basis. Or on an annual basis, and then maybe work on improving your list of keywords. But for now, let's just save and continue the ad group. The next step, which is the last step as you can see, is create ads. So let me create an ad. This is how your ad is going to look like. You can add all the URLs here. So let me get started. Let me just open my website to select the link I want to promote. I want to promote this link, how to create Snapchat ads. Let me quickly open the URL builder and create a link for it. Google CPC Snapchat ad. You can copy the link, paste it on the final URL. you can decide how the link here is going to be. So right now it's by default vareinbear.com. I can add Snapchat here, something like that. Give your ad a description as well. Now I've added the content. You can add custom parameters to the URL, add a tracking template, but I really don't need this since I've already added my template here. You can also use a different URL for mobile, which I don't need because my website is responsive. You can see how your ad looks on desktop and mobile. Save and continue. And my campaign is live. I'm inside the campaign right now. I can see the ad group that I created, the CPC, and here you can basically monitor your clicks and impressions and things like that. I'll also show you how to add conversions here later. The conversions come from Google Analytics. Google Analytics can get integrated with Google AdWords so that you can see your conversions here as well and directly know how much you're paying for conversions on your website. But that's a story for another tutorial. That is about it for this tutorial. I hope you now know how to create your search ad. Please get started with it. If you have any questions, do comment it below and I'll be more than happy to answer it for you. Thank you so much. Hey everyone, this is Viren and thank you for watching this video. I really do put in a lot of effort in making these videos. So if you did like the video, hit the thumbs up button, comment and please let me know. And subscribe to this channel because I come up with these content on a regular basis and you might find them helpful. Thank you.